Of all the shows I've ever done, I once did a show with a lady called Arlene Dahl. And for some reason, I guess because she writes a beauty column, all the women say, is she really so gorgeous in person? One of the truth? Most gorgeous woman I ever saw in my life. Did you ever hate anybody instantly? There was nothing wrong with this woman. She had red patent leather hair. And did you ever say to yourself, how do those movie stars stay so young? They never have lines and wrinkles. You know why? When they laugh, they never move their skin like this. I told her a joke. She laughed. I thought she had cramps. How'd you like to spend the night with her? And you never saw skin like porcelain. You know that kind of skin? I looked at her and said, oh, God, make her have a pimple, a black at a hole. Nothing, gorgeous nose, big green eyes. She had a mole. It was even in the right place. If I had a mole, it'd be hanging off the end of my nose. People said, what's a black ball hanging from your nose? And she's a lovely lady. We sat like this, look. Chit-chat, chit-chat. 1 hour she sat. She got out of a chair. She didn't have a wrinkle. Not a wrinkle. Then I got up. Sarah Slob got up out of a chair. Looked like I slept in a dress for 2 years. Mike said, get ready for the show. I was ready. I just looked lousy next to her. And you know the worst sickness in the whole world. Do you know what it is, sweetheart? Envy. Don't ever envy anybody. You hear? See, this broad envies me. Don't, because you know what? Because I'm the happiest woman alive. Do you know that? I swear to you, I have everything that's important in life. I'm so contented, I'm like a cow. Moo. And I envied Arlene Dahl. I said, it must be great to be that beautiful and to have a body that men drop dead over you. Right, kids? Yeah? I'm so sick of being everybody's buddy. Yeah, just wants to pick up a paper and read. Totie feels raped in an alley. I put on new underwear every night just to get ready. And then you know what? I look at a woman like that who has everything and I pick up a newspaper. You know what I read? Arlene Dahl just divorced her fourth husband. Isn't that strange to have all that going for you and lose five, how many, four guys? No, it's true. I forget who was in bed with me. Hiya, Irving. No, this one's Harriet. Looks like Irving. How can a woman go through four guys? Look at this. Look what's going on here. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. 19 years with the same guy. I must be doing something right, kids, huh? You better believe it. My old man smiles a lot. See, no, you know what I believe? I say a woman is not a woman unless she's loved. You believe that, honey? Absolutely. How many years you married in? 22 years. That's nice. I like to hear that. See, I think everyone's got to be loved. I don't care where you get it or from who. You know, that's your own problem. I look at a woman like that, I say, I wonder if she ever bought Santa Flush. You think she ever washed a toilet in her whole life? She's so rich, I don't even know who she goes, you know? Well, they have servants for everything, you know? She could call in a maid I have to make. That's it, it's all over. I look at a woman like Arlene Dahl and say, I wonder if she ever bought a flunkin' in her whole life. That's how you stay normal, a flunkin', that's right. You don't know what a flunkin' is? I'm a flunkin'. It's a good hunk of Jewish meat. Could you picture Arlene Dahl going to the butcher? Hi, I'd like a hunk of flunkin'. Now, we'll go on further. Arlene Dahl writes a beauty column. So she went into the audience that day, she gave beauty hints. I'm saying, what are they listening if Arlene Dahl told you what to do? Would you look like Arlene Dahl? Right, shouldn't I write a beauty column? More women look like me than Arlene Dahl. Right, here's what she said. She said, a woman should not get sloppy or her husband will run away with another woman. She's saying yes. Look at this nut. Look at this nut. She's just said yes. I want you to stand up here and show these people. Stand up here. Look at this nut just said yes. Who cares? Turn around. Look at this. Who cares if you look sloppy, you idiot? Sit down. Where does Sue sit down too? Look at this. His mustache just curled this way instead of the other one. Dirty old man. No, darling. Neatness has nothing to do with it. You hear what I tell you? Just like people say, Totie, are you a good cook? No, but I'm a great wife. You understand that? I married my Georgie the first day I said to him, Georgie, pick out which room you want me to be great in. I cannot excel in every room in the house. I'm sorry. Thank God he goes out to eat. Hey, you show me a woman busy in the kitchen the whole day, I'll show you a guy fooling around with one that isn't. Right, girls? Right, let the Girl Scouts push their cookies. Now, we shall go on again. Here's what she said, kids. Shh. Because these are pearls, wisdom. She said a woman should take stock of herself. She should wake up one morning and stand stark naked in front of a mirror with a pencil and paper. And she should list her assets and her liabilities. Well, the next day I had nothing to do, you know? I was sitting around the house, I said, this is a nice day to stand naked. I had had my flu shot, and my fungus was clearing up nicely, you know? So I'm standing in front of the mirror naked with my pencil and paper. Do you know what a sight that is? Looked like the sinking of the Titanic. And my husband walked in. You try to look casual. You got no pockets, you don't know what to do with your hands. He's looking at me like it's all over. He says, what are you doing? I said, I'm having my 1,000-mile checkup. Little oil and grease, I should be as good as new. I said, would you believe I'm selling Girl Scout cookies? I have nowhere to hang my badge. I'm not afraid of him. I said, listen, Arlene Dahl told me to stand naked in front of a mirror with a pencil and paper and list my assets and my liabilities, and I did it, girls. And I went bankrupt.